you see this chart? Oh my gosh, it is so overwhelming. When I look at this, I just can't help but be completely overwhelmed by it. I mean, I think that's the word for it. Today, we're going to be discussing certifications in technology and cybersecurity in general. Let's seize the day. I'm Megan Jacko, and this is Carpe Diem Tech. Now, this visual might be overwhelming. We can also break it down, and it can be quite helpful. So thank you, Paul Jeremy, for putting this together and collecting all this data. Depending on when you're looking at this, this is from a specific time. So depending on when you're watching this video, you might look at this and see, oh, okay, this data is from 2021. And so there could be something that is missing depending on when you watch this video. Just kind of keep that in mind. However, no matter when you're watching this, the structure is going to be the same. I recommend starting at the top for navigation because those are the 8 different large categories that things are broken into. So if we start from left to right, we have communication, network security, identity access management, then we have security, architecture and engineering, asset security, security and risk management, security assessments, software security, and then security operations. Now, some of these categories have subcategories to them. So we can see that really quite largely within security operations that is broken into forensics, incident handling, pen testing, and exploitation. So those are all subsections of the security operations. And then a couple other ones that have subsections. Governance, regulation, and compliance within the risk management section. And then security, architecture, and engineering, we have some cloud security pieces. We have some software pieces with Linux and different software things. And then we have some IoT pieces here, Internet of Things pieces. So those are some of the subcategories that exist. Now, as you can see me moving the mouse around, you might see different things popping up. And so that's actually one of the things that I do want to highlight about this resource. So even though it looks like overwhelming, kind of a little daunting, it can be really helpful because each of these is hyperlinked to the assessments. And so it gives you pieces of information as you just highlight it, but then you can click to that. So for example, this top one here, you can see that is a GEC test, and you can see the pricing for that, and that it has an exam and a lab and an in-person lab component to it. The other thing that you want to look at when you're reading this is where these tests fall into. This is particularly helpful if you are trying to do one of two things. Maybe you are completely new to cybersecurity and you're trying to figure out, what do I do? Where do I specialize? How do I have proof of concept that I know what I know? The other way it could be very helpful is if you're in one part of cybersecurity and you want to move to a different part. So let's first speak to new to cyber people. So you're new to cyber and you're trying to come up with some proof of concepts. Well, you're going to want to take a certification that is going to most broadly appeal and be very generalist because it's going to showcase that you know a variety of different things. And also, you aren't yet in a specialty, so it doesn't make sense to do one of the specialty certifications. So you can see the certifications that band across many of the different things. So, you know, like your Security Plus that obviously many people hear about. And then something with maybe a programming language, or maybe some of these different things where it's like that Security Essential certification. So those could be some really good options for you. Now, in this CompTIA one here as well, this one you can see here does band across many different ones. However, I would not recommend that for your new to cyber or not in the industry yet, because that is one that requires multiple years of experience in industry. So even though it goes across many different parts, that's because that's a position for people who are often in leadership within cybersecurity, and so they need to have an idea about many different pieces of cybersecurity. So that's not a good one for new to cyber. Then the other thing is if you are trying to switch from one field to another field. Like, let's say, you know, you've already been specializing in identity access management, right? Maybe you have some of these certifications. What if you wanted to switch fields and you're like, wow, I am really fascinated with forensics. So then this can be really good to look at and think about maybe a forensic certification that you want to have as a goal. And I'm not saying that you have to have certifications, that is the end all be all, that is a must thing that you have to do. But this is a useful visual for seeing certifications that exist out there. And certifications can be useful as a method for showcasing that you know something, potentially, you know, one of the ways that you can showcase that. So, not everyone thinks that certifications are a good thing. There's a lot of thought process around, like, you know, we have too many certifications. So I'm very happy to entertain other thoughts on it. I didn't create this. And so if you have other thoughts on certifications, if you think we should get rid of them, if you're really for them and you're like, they're great, I would love to hear your thoughts and ideas on certifications. And if you're working on a certification, let me know. So those would be great things to put in the comments. I'd love to hear from you about that. Any questions that you might have as well. And I just wanted to share this resource with you. I think that even though it is a bit overwhelming, it is also helpful. I hope you have a great rest of your day. Be well and carpe diem. Please like this video and subscribe to the Carpe Diem Tech YouTube channel for more videos like this. Thank you.